9 more holes. 9 more holes. We got 9 more holes of disc golf. It's Jamie Thomas, SpinTV, you know where you are. It's the 2017 Aussie Open final round. Back 9, bringing home the first major in the first disc golf world tour event of the season. You already know, Wysocki, McMahon, Kajiyama, McBeth, in no particular order. Ricky made a SpinTV debut on the commentary yesterday, joining Avery for the back 9. Congratulations, Rick. Happy to have you. Only 2 back. The world champ sitting from the mile high cannon, Eagle McMahon. This time yesterday, Eagle had a 6-stroke lead and Ricky was able to cut it to 3 after stumbling here on this par 4, hole number 10. He's since made up another stroke on the front 9. And the only sin here is to go left. Keep the disc right off that tee. No problem there. And if there's one weakness in Kajiyama's game, it's the driver's flexing out on him sometimes. It's happened a few different times, namely on hole 3. Eagle's in decent position there. Here's an aggressive look by Paul. Stopped a little short, but he hit the gap. Ricky using the leaves and the trees. Use the course to play the course. And an excellent upshot once again by Kajiyama. There's no doubt birdie for Paul. And it's like Ricky was saying, on all these par fours, Eagle's distance is really separating him. He's had a jump putter, an easy putter. And he hasn't really needed to go for many of the eagles, just securing the birdies. One hole ticks off the remaining 8 to go, and he maintains that 2-stroke lead, making it hard for Ricky to make any moves. See you on the other side.
Always thrown Innova and competed with Innova. I don't think I'd be playing the sport if it wasn't for him creating the disc itself and then just taking it to the next level over and over and over again. How great the discs are themselves, it's really gained my trust, and I don't think I would be here without Innova. I don't see myself doing anything else.
Hole 11. Just like the front 9, back 9 starts off with a pair of par 4s. Big OB section. Trap on this fairway. More of a C-shaped fairway than a dog leg. Let's see. Ricky's gets a good bit close to that 12th fairway. Doesn't get that turnover. Here's Kajiyama.
Nice shot.
That's Japanese for smooth. He puts himself in such great position to attack the pin on a second shot. And that's good IQ by Eagle there, knowing he doesn't have to take the roller that he tried yesterday. There's no need to get too aggressive. Paul, on the other hand, no reason to not go for it. He does. That's a big shot.
Safe, I guess.
Yeah, baby.
Clear in the OB, and he has an eagle look. And Ricky showing off the putter forehand touch. Can't emphasize it enough. It's not as easy as they make it look. I feel like I may be partially at fault for that. Eagle's gonna have a tough putt, or he's gonna give up one of those two very valuable strokes. Paul's run never really had a chance there, but easy birdie. And that's a clutch putt right there, when you need to have it. Just going barely underneath that band, catching one of the top links. Ricky's body language says it all right there. He thought he got a stroke on him. He thought the young buck would feel the pressure of the moment. But instead, that's a star frame. Two strokes, seven to play. And of course, we've saved the hardest hole on the course for right now. Third par four in a row. Ricky and Eagle have been attacking this hole differently. Different methods all weekend. Let's see if they stick to their guns or change it up. Ricky's probably content to let Eagle take that riskier route. And that's a nice, confident forehand. It's probably his best drive on this hole all week. A little slip there from Manabu. Eagle is not afraid to go for it. It looks like he got caught up. He did not get that far down the fairway, but he did clear the trees, which is, again, all he really needs to do. And here's Paul. Looking for it to go big, and we lost it. Looks like Paul's drive just didn't get high enough and got knocked down. Second shot hit something as well. You go with a little more aggressive look with this putter. Right at the mouth of the green. Flashed one of the four rings there. Paul just hasn't put it together this week quite like the rest, or like these other two. And it's unfortunate because the pace that Eagle and Rick are setting is... I mean, they're playing at such a level that it makes everybody else look like they're not playing that great at disc golf, when I'm telling you, there's nothing wrong with the rounds that these other guys are putting down. rain starts to fall here. Good solid putt from McBeth. Right in the heart. Ricky follows with a drain of his own. And we'll finish out here. Hardest hole on the course. Ricky's birdie is crucial right there. Brings him within one stroke, makes Eagle pay for playing it safe. We go on to the musket, the hole 13. This will be a test of nerves. One of the easiest shots on the course. Can you execute it? Rick says yes. Yeah. And that is going to be a tester. Manabu says, I'm coming for you, Paul. Not so fast, says McBeth. Good lanky straddle. Rick makes short work of that. Star frame. Star frame for the lead card. We are coming down the stretch. Five holes to play. Hole 14, so dangerous, the middle of that fairway, the way it squeezes down right in front of that net on the left side. OB runs all the way behind the basket. The golf green also serving as a dangerous trap that we watched a bunch of players find yesterday. And Rick's negotiated that fairway nicely, counting on a little bit of reduced skip due to the rain. Eagle has thrown. He's thrown that leapfrog shot. He's going to put the pressure on Ricky with the longer upshot. That rain is really starting to fall now. Softening the course up. Paul yanked that one a little bit, but it seems to be overstable enough. Center fairway. This is a scary upshot. And Ricky has played it very nicely. Learned from the mistake of yesterday, playing wide of that little hillside to elevate that golf green. Skips right around it. Might have been a little slip there from Kajiyama. Footing on this hole is downhill as well. Runs a slow downhill. It's a little tough, especially if you're going to run up. Don't be short. McBeth has struggled with this hole. Oh, an eagle inside the bullseye ring. McBeth for birdie. Sorted out that putt in the last couple holes. Saw him missing left earlier in the round, earlier in the week. And this is a must-have. And he gets it. No doubts there. Straight to the heart. The lead remains one. This back nine on this course is just diabolical. You have the three par fours, then the musket, then another downhill par four, and then this par three here, which is a trap hole. You've heard him talking about it all week. The skip factor on this hole, avoiding that little ridge, as you can see. They put those throughout the golf course here as erosion control due to the slant and the dry nature of the fairways. Makes a great element for a disc golf course, but it is wet, so we may see some reduced skip here. And that's wide, it needs to get back in bounds. And it does, staring right at the basket. A little more height, a little more velocity. And the eagle just will not yield. Ricky is gonna have to take it from him on this hole. Paul with the don't forget about me shot. And Kajiyama the fourth. CTP. And there's the dagger from Ricky. So good with that putter. He stares down to the link, puts it right where it needs to be. Eagle follows with a solid putt of his own. And this is what you want to see, the best players playing the best golf. The victory will be earned here at Mundaring today. We've only got three holes left. We've got a dangerous par five coming up. We've seen rollers. We've seen shots go over 600 feet. We've seen shots go to the left and to the right. All kinds of ways to play this 1,230-foot downhill bomber par 5. Ricky goes for the outside roller, just like the third round. And there's a patience to his game that he didn't have a couple years ago, where he may have pushed. He's content to set it out there, see if the younger McMahon makes the mistake, but so far, Eagle's matched him shot for shot on this back nine, and there's a big destroyer shot by Paul. Don't think that one's quite as big as the second round, but probably just means he has two out of the top three furthest drives on this hole. Manabu is going to be tucked there. May require a patent pending or some kind of straddle out shot. Important shot for Eagle. Getting a good bit of slide. And Rick looks like he wants this one in three. Good dodge there by the local spectators. Tough to find those white discs against a bright gray sky, I will tell you. I've been there, boys. I know how that feels.
Oh, you let it slip right out of your hand.
Oh. And you can hear him talking to himself there. Got slippy on him. This intermittent rain has decided to pick up once again. Manabu. That's going to be a birdie for him. That's high and right. He needs it to stop. And that's a tester. That could be big trouble for Ricky. If Eagle can capitalize here. And it looks like he does. For Eagle. Oh my god, nobody else in the world but Paul McBeth, ladies and gentlemen. Just showing you how it's done. You think his back feels a little bit better? Coming off of a injury-riddled 2016 campaign. He's just getting warmed up, folks. And that is devastating for Ricky. And Eagle will capitalize, moving his lead to two strokes with two to play. We may have just seen the winning upshot from Eagle McMahon. Ricky, he has to push now. There's no time left. All systems go. Eagle by Paul. Pair of birdies by Eagle and Manabu. Ricky pars. And now it's do or die. This green is so dangerous. Too long, too far left. And you're looking at a guarded putt. Short and you're OB with a drop zone that makes a par difficult. Paul's hunting aces here. Whew. Back in 2015, he aced this hole 2 days in a row in practice. That might be high. Oh no. Eagle making the only mistake that you cannot make on this hole. To wonder what he was thinking. You have two strokes, you don't need to push, and the door swings wide open for Ricky here. And he is not going to risk that left side. He is going to put the pressure right back on Eagle. This may tie them. Oh my god. Goodness, Eagle McMahon. Does the kid even know what pressure is? Holy cow, I don't even have any words right now. If there was ever a putt needed in any major, that was it. Paul. Last four holes. Birdie, birdie, eagle, birdie. Deuce for Manabu as well. Another star frame. The last three par threes. Or excuse me, not a star frame. Eagle's putt felt like one, but the nerves, the pressure. One hole, one stroke. One more commercial. Be right back. And it all comes down to this. It's only 95 meters, 312 feet OB left, all around the green. Excuse me, playing like an island. Island green, fraught with danger. Paul leads us off. Using the hard pan as a backboard. Paul has a putt. Manabu looks good out of his hand. Bullseye. And here it is to put pressure. He has to have this. A par will not do here.
Shot right.
And he's not gonna par. Eagle McMahon with a birdie could win his first major. And that's wide. And he is OB. And now he has to make this. Oh my goodness, ladies and gentlemen, to come so close, to have fought down to the wire, to make the putt on 17.
Ladies and gentlemen, third place, Aussie Open, Paul McBeth.
And just to come so close, you gotta feel for the kid. Manabu taps in. And your winner. First Disc Golf World Tour event. First PDGA Major of 2017. We talked about it. The patience that he showed on that back six. He just waited and waited and he bided his time. And it all paid off for the reigning world champion. His victory here now means he's had the last four seasons with a major. Taken eagle by one stroke. 10 strokes over Paul McBeth, 14 over Manabu. Let's roll into the disc golf metrics for the final round. And there's the tail right there. Ricky Wysocki, 89% greens hit. Eagle was 67. Despite being the only person on the card to miss an inside the circle putt, he played his way to a 16 down round. Let's not let that get lost in the drama of what just unfolded. Ricky Wysocki threw a 17 down and a 16 down. That's the level he had to play to win this tournament by one stroke on the final hole. Here's your top 10. Philo. Two strokes behind Manabu, Posse, Greg. And Avery Jenkins doing double duty, stayed in the top 10. And that's going to be it from Aussie, guys. Next time you'll see us, SpinTV, we're going to be at the 2017 Gentlemen's Club Challenge presented by Innova. Hope you'll tune in there. We're going to have live streaming, edited coverage. See you guys then.